right, everybody. Again, I like the chatter. We're having a great discussion. So we want to take a moment now to hear some of the great things that you guys talked about at your tables so that everyone could get a peek in, at least, to what you discussed. Again, we're just going to report out your most significant thoughts, and we're going to give each table about a minute to do so, so that we can get on with our program. And we'll be going to, once we get everybody, all the discussions out and we talk a little bit, then we're going to take a break and then we'll come back and have our next presentation. So we're going to start over here with our first report out.
Hello. Hi. So I'm
Sue.
I'm going to give you the answer to the first question.
You can give us whatever was most significant.
Okay.
First question, second question, whatever you guys think was most significant.
Okay. So they had, for the first question, actually, they had a lot of answers for that. From Bill Rivas and Aaron Scott, they're from San Jose Water Company. They manage a lot of the linear assets, a lot of them, actually. Pipelines and services and valves and hydrants. And what stood out about the second presentation was, how they do asset management on the watershed. And the creek level. So for them, it was very interesting that, they go back all the way there. And they just, they usually concentrate on the asset, but assets actually apply to a lot of things, not only parks and valves, but also, the watersheds and the creeks. Another thing is the top-down commitment. So somebody was saying here that it takes the top-down commitment to do something about asset management. And sometimes, when you don't have that person at the top that is willing to make a change, it's hard because you just have what you have and you kind of became a slave to the system that you actually have. So it's very important if you actually mention it. So, he says that sometimes you're not nearly there because of that. It takes a top down. So from the point of view of other people here, they say that when they started the asset management program, they actually formed a committee. So they had an asset management committee and they had people from all of the groups involved. So then they had, it's easy to get everybody involved. And the person at the top was, he wrote a letter saying this is very important, so I want everybody committed. So that it makes a big difference. The other thing is sometimes it's hard when you don't have a specific group doing asset management, that sometimes your time is taken away from doing the day-to-day stuff, and if you have to do on top of that asset management plus your normal stuff, it's hard to do that, and there are so many hours in the day, so it's hard to actually do both of them, and there are priorities. There are day-to-day things that you have to respond to. That's actually important. And from Mount View Sanitary District, they were just talking about how they have already done their prioritization, but they haven't done the planning. So that's going to be the next step. So that's kind of like an answer to question number two, where they are actually doing the planning and figuring out the which assets are going to replace. So there's a lot of things that happen.
Thank you. For time's sake, please just take a minute to give us your most significant thoughts from your take.
For the Napa Sand presentation, we really like the idea of having multiple units having input on how data is collected whenever you're doing assessments of your assets. From an engineering perspective, I don't have a lot of intuitive ideas about what kind of data should be collected on how to improve certain, pipeline vaults or manhole access, things that I would never think about that would be intuitive, things that I would completely miss. And so if you involve maintenance or other units in how you collect data on your assets, it helps diversify how you understand or how you prioritize what needs to be fixed for certain assets. And for the second presentation, we liked how each performance standard was broken down into individual, it was broken down into tasks that could be clearly identified so that you have milestones that you can meet easily. And it's really easy to see how higher assets are being affected by how you're prioritizing them and what tasks actually need to be prioritized.
Thank you. Next table.
You want to speak?
Next table.
Yeah. All right. We'll just start.
From Robin's presentation, we like the fact that NAPA has an agency plan with a timeline and financial costs established to it. There was a comment that we've done a lot of work, but don't have a big picture like they do to kind of determine where all the work we've done fits into a larger plan. And then from Lizzie's presentation, it was good to be aware of that EPA 10-step asset management planning model to be able to look at that and develop a roadmap of where the asset management plan needs to go.
Thank you.
So from Lizzie's presentation, we particularly like the mobile devices that we use in the field. That's something that we're moving forward to. And we just feel that those are so helpful, especially for linear guys out in the field trying to find things. We also like that trying to use the CMNS to capture everything. So everything's in one source. And also the annual reports. It's always good to be able to give a good report to your board members and also to the public to show where their money is being spent at and what you're doing with it. And then Robin's presentation, it was nice that our board was the one that started the whole asset management. And they're the ones that run the district. So that was good that the board recognized that and pretty much led us to move forward with that. The other thing too is, as he mentioned, we had a buy-in from all departments. We had the collection guys, the administration people, engineering, maintenance, even the operators, everybody bought in and had a say-so and how we're going to move forward with it. And also, the breakdown in phases, the cost was really high, so they broke it down in phases, and we also set milestones to complete those phases, which is something that was achievable. So that's something we can show up with.
Thank you.
So with regards to time, one of the things that was really that popped out to us was the phasing and how the phases were separated into sub-phasing. And we are currently in the process of introducing a new management system, and we may incorporate sub-phasing into the next few phases.
Great.
So a few things that we spoke about was the importance of getting involvement from the team, involvement from all departments throughout the organization, to get everybody's buy-in and support and get ownership basically from everybody, as well as getting support and approval from the board as well. Some more things we discussed was that there's different approaches for different districts, and there's not one answer to this whole thing. We also talked about that a lot of agencies have asset management in some capacity, but those may not be a formal project per se, and making it more of a formal process it brings improvement to the overall asset management. And another thing that came up was it's not always easy to identify assets in general and how far to break them down, which came out in the last session.
Thank you.
We have a few that have this. One was breaking down the structure, for example, the different levels, like for example, power wire, how far do you break that down? You have different components, mechanical, structural, concrete, how far do we break it down? Second was how important the budget is and the impact of having a good asset management program and the resources, seeing how other folks approach different size organizations. Some people have to wear many hats and don't have a formal asset management team or analyst and so on. And some big takeaways is the opportunity to network, working together to share ideas like scoring assets, for example, because that's always a challenge. And good to hear from multiple folks' experiences.
Thank you.
On the first presentation from NAPA SAN, we brought, again, different disciplines on the asset management
little closer, please.
Sorry, is that better?
Yes. From Napa Sand, different disciplines on the asset management team is important. It's not enough to just consult with other areas, but to have those people on your team and maybe rotate different people in, because in my case, operations is huge, so have different operational people be part of that team for a given period, so we get all over the district, get everything. And the second presentation, asset condition assessment is a must. It's got to get done any way you do it. And if hardware in the field makes a difference, and you need to work on that. And I think that just hearing that different agencies have wrestled with different hardware in the field, maybe we can network with each other to find out what is the best hardware to use.
Thank you.
We discussed mainly the connection between CMS and SAP and, GIS, and how essential that link is needed for asset management down the road. It takes a lot of work up in the beginning, but down the line, it can really drive where the program goes and how your decisions are made. That's mainly what our discussion is going on.
Thank you.
For our table, and we're mainly focused on from the first presentation that Robbie mentioned, they're trying to consolidate three databases into one database. But from our table, and because from the Santa Clara Valley Water District, they have a variety of the responsibility, including watershed, water utility. So it seems like from watershed and the people more tuned to use the maximal, but from the water utility side, and we're also looking into like the GIS based to incorporate all the pipelines and all the appurtenance. And so we're also looking to doing some civil 3D and to have a hydraulic model component built into the database. So we're kind of encounter different thoughts, and so that's something we're trying to wrestle with. And I know from Ed is from SMPUC. And his thought is about how we can communicate with the information technology firm and to have more all-inclusive software to capture all the features and the components to suit for all the applications, and how we can convey this message or whatever the functions we're looking for from the water industry to the information technology firms to better suit
our purpose. So that's something we focus on in our table. Thank you. So, I mean, pretty much everybody said most of the things we've talked about, but after the last table. So I would just echo the sentiment of the importance of making sure that you have buy-in from management, from the board level in our case. Making sure you have a concrete plan with identified resource requirements and milestones that you're going to need those requirements to meet. And the other issue that I would echo is making an explicit goal of centralizing your databases and your applications for asset management. A few people at the table talked about how we have lots of different software tools. It's difficult to get everybody pointing at the same database.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I think from working backwards from the presentation, the question was how can this work with sewer rehab and condition assessment with working with the Creek people? And my thought was too, could this also be used in deconstructing a creek from taking a sediment creek and daylight creek rather than constructing a creek working backwards? And then for Napa, the talk was about timeline and milestones. They really like the idea, big people milestones, achievable goals to keep the enthusiasm going. There were questions about deferred maintenance and using the budget and spot repairs just to keep a small budget intact. More kind of how can we do that? is how would this work? And how does this work with lining, sewer lining and so on? And how does this work maybe with child assets and spot repair, what's being spot repair?
Thank you.
Thank you, and again, a lot of things have been covered. As far as Napa Sand is concerned, we felt that they've set themselves up for success by starting with a top-down approach, getting the board to create the charter, develop the impetus for the change, the strategic approach involving all participants in the asset lifecycle in the asset plan and the strategies, and redeveloping the asset management tactics, excuse me, all the way down to how do we get the data, what do we do with it, consolidating everything into one database, which segues into the old woman that presented on the creeks. A challenge that she'll be faced with there is the report compilation at the end of the year. Everybody wants to know what's the state of our assets. The more you can concentrate that data, pull it from one place, and institutionalize the process, the more sustainable that process is going to be.
Thank you.